स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न कॉन्वर्स, इनवर्स एंड कॉन्ट्रापॉजिटिव ऑफ अ कंडीशनल स्टेटमेंट, क्वांटिफायर्स, क्वांटिफाइड स्टेटमेंट्स एंड ड्यूल्स ऑफ स्टेटमेंट पैटर्न्स। सो फर्स्ट लेट स्टडी कॉन्वर्स, इनवर्स एंड कॉन्ट्रापॉजिटिव ऑफ अ कंडीशनल स्टेटमेंट। इफ अ गिवन कंडीशनल स्टेटमेंट इज पी एम्प्लाइज क्यू, then its converse is q implies p, that is if q then p. Its inverse is negation p implies negation q, that is if negation p then negation q. And contrapositive is negation q implies negation p, that is if negation q then negation of p. Consider this example to write converse, inverse and contrapositive. Given conditional statement is if x is less than y, then 2x is less than 2y. So let's take p as x is less than y and statement q as 2x is less than 2y. So given conditional statement is p implies q. Now if given conditional statement is p implies q, then its converse is q implies p. We have to interchange p and q. So interchanging p and q, converse is q implies p. That is if q then p. So just we have to insert those statements in the places of p and q. So if q then p means if 2x is less than 2y, then x is less than y. Now next is inverse. Inverse is negation p implies negation q. That means if negation of p then negation of q. So if negation of p, now statement p is x is less than y. So its negation is x is not less than y. So either we can write it as x is not less than y, or we can write it as x is greater than or equal to y. Remember, it is not x greater than y, it is x greater than or equal to y. Similarly, negation q is 2x is greater than or equal to 2y. Therefore, inverse is if negation p then negation q, that means if x is greater than or equal to y, then 2x is greater than or equal to 2y. Next is contrapositive. Contrapositive is negation q implies negation of p. That means if negation q, then negation p. That means if 2x is greater than or equal to 2y, then x is greater than or equal to y. Let's consider one more example to write converse, inverse and contrapositive. Here the given conditional statement is if f of 2 equal to 0, then fx is divisible by x minus 2. So first write the statements p and q. So p part is f of 2 equal to 0 and q is the statement fx is divisible by x minus 2. So given statement is p implies q. Now you try to write down the statement with me. Converse is q implies p. So if q means fx is divisible by x minus 2, then p, that is f of 2 equal to 0. So converse is if fx is divisible by x minus 2, then f of 2 equal to 0. Next is inverse. Inverse is negation p implies negation q. That is if f2 not equal to 0, then fx is not divisible by x minus 2. Contrapositive is negation q implies negation p. So if negation q, then negation p. So if negation q means fx is not divisible by x minus 2, then negation p is f of 2 not equal to 0. Now consider quantifiers and quantified statements. So first quantifier is existential quantifier. So sign of existential quantifier is given here. Existential quantifier means there exist. That means for at least one of the element or one of the member, the statement should be true. And second is universal quantifier. Sign is given here. Universal quantifier means for every. So the statement should be true for all the members. Let's consider this example. Set A contains the elements 3, 5, 7, 9, 11 and 12. The question is determine the truth value of the following statements. So first statement is there exist x belongs to A such that x minus 5 equal to 7. So first the quantifier given is there exist. The statement is true only when it is true for at least one of the member. So x minus 5 equal to 7 is true only when x is equal to 12 and 12 is one of the element of set A. So the statement is true for 12 and the statement starts with there exist. So it is true for one of the member, therefore the truth value is T. Now second statement is for every x belongs to A, x square plus x is an even number. See now the quantifier given is for every E. So this should be true, if this is true then this should be true for all the members. Let's consider first member, that is 3. So 3 square plus 3. 3 square is 9. 9 plus 3 is 12 and 12 is an even number. So you can check this for each and every number from set A. Or we can consider like this, x square plus x. So if we take x common, it becomes x into x plus 1. And since here we have all natural numbers, x into x plus 1. X and x plus 1 are consecutive natural numbers. And one of the member is even number. So the product is even number. Either x is even or if x is odd, then x plus 1 has to be even. So the product is even number. So it is true for all natural numbers. So it has to be true for all the members of A also. Therefore, the statement is true. Therefore, its truth value is T. Now the third statement is, there exists x belongs to A such that x square is less than 0. Now here, all the members of A are natural numbers. And square of a natural number is always positive. And here the square is given less than 0, that means it is negative number. So this is not possible for any of the natural numbers. Therefore, the statement is false. Therefore, its truth value is F. Now consider the last statement. For every x belongs to A, 5x minus 2 is less than 20. So let's check for each and every number. So for x is equal to 3, we get 5 into 3. 15 minus 2, 13 less than 20, it is correct. For x is equal to 5, substituting 5 in 5x minus 2, we get 5 into 5, that is 25. 25 minus 2 is 23. Is 23 less than 20? No, it is wrong. 23 is not less than 20. So the statement is false for x is equal to 5. And it starts with for every. So its truth value will be T only when it is true for all the members. And for 5 it is false. Therefore, the statement is false. Therefore, its truth value is F. Next definition is of dual of a statement. The condition to write dual of a statement, the given statement pattern should be in terms of negation, conjunction and disjunction. That means it should be in terms of negation, or, and. So rule to write dual of a statement pattern is interchange, or and. That means disjunction and conjunction. And if the statement contains tautology or contradiction, we have to interchange tautology and contradiction as well. So let's consider this example. Write dual of the following statements. So first statement pattern given here is negation P or negation Q and P or Q and negation R. Remember that we have to interchange or and. That means conjunction and disjunction and tautology and contradiction. So negation P we have to write as it is. Then we have the sign for disjunction. So convert that disjunction into conjunction. That means or is replaced by and. Then we have negation Q. Again, in the given statement we have and. So interchanging that we get or. In the round bracket we have or. So replace it with and. And the last one is and. So replacing it by or, dual will be negation of P and negation Q or P and Q or negation R. Now second statement is P or Q and contradiction. So interchange or with and contradiction with tautology. So the dual will be P and Q or T. Now you can check with yourself for the third and fourth statement. Third statement is negation P or Q and R and tautology. So the dual will be negation P instead of R, now it is and. Q and R becomes Q or R and tautology becomes or contradiction. Similarly, for the fourth statement, P and tautology is logically equivalent to P. Dual is P or contradiction is logically equivalent to P. This is your assignment. Write duals of the following statements. Thank you. I will see you in the next video.